Cashiers, lifeguards, and waitresses are all three totally different jobs that all have one thing in common. They're all minimum wage jobs. Minimum wage, as I'm sure many of you know, is the lowest amount that an employer is required to pay an employee. Only one key issue separates the lower and upper working classes on the issue of minimum wage, whether the United States minimum wage rate should be raised. Today, I will be discussing the inherent issues regarding this issue, including the effects on businesses and society, the cost of living changes. To start with the effects on businesses, people who are for raising the minimum wage rate say that local businesses would gain more business. According to the debate on minimum wage, an article found on procon.org, minimum wage increases boost sales at local businesses as workers buy goods and services they could not afford before. So if someone who relies off of a minimum wage rate job, say in the lower class, their income would be essentially doubling if it went from $7.50 to $15. So they would be able to not have to budget as much, and they would be buying more at the store, giving small businesses more money. People who are against this say that companies would have to raise their prices on their products to offset the high labor costs that come with raising the minimum wage rate. So if a company has to go from paying their employees $7.50 to $15, which is basically double, they will have to double their prices on the products that they sell, so they're making more money, or the same amount of money that they were before. For the effects on society, more money for people to have to spend would mean less poverty. According to Jeanette Wicks-Lynn, author of The Case for $15, an article I found on Inspire, if there is a 3% raise for workers and a 1.5 decrease in their hours, there's an overall improvement since earnings are made up of wages and hours worked. So someone could go from working, say, 40 hours a week to 25 hours a week and would essentially be making the same amount of money, if not more, which would reduce stress and tiredness. People against raising it say that less experienced workers would be put out of a job because if employers are going to have to start paying their employees more, they're going to want someone who has experience in that field, so they're getting the best bang for their buck. The cost of living would also be drastically changed by this, so people for raising it say that the cost of living would essentially be improved because the upper class wouldn't be affected because there's not any additional like tax charges or anything like that, so they're not losing money. And then the lower class is gaining money so they can afford rent and groceries and things that they wouldn't have been able to afford before. And it would also help economic recovery and small businesses because the small businesses would be getting more business from everyone and it would gain them more money. People against this say that a minimum wage job is only for people with minimum skills. So they're not used to teach entry-level people. They're used to teach entry-level people skills, they're not used to be things that people will rely on for the rest of their life. According to procon.org, research shows that businesses would respond to higher costs by increasing unemployment for low-skilled workers and passing higher costs onto consumers. Minimum wage does little, if anything, to decrease poverty. In conclusion, minimum wage has always and probably will always be surrounded by a vast amount of opinions. As I end my speech, I encourage you all to consider the inherent issues and the facts regarding minimum wage from both sides.
Amount would probably go down just because, like I said, more
businesses will be won't be able to afford as many workers as they would before, so they would have to probably like lower down the amount of workers they have just so they can still keep on making money and still.
What percentage of people have like a minimum wage job?
I saw online when I was reading that out of the working class, 3.3% of workers work a full-time minimum wage rate job as like their only job that they need, their only source of income.
Because of the minimum wage going up, do you think people are going to stop going to college because they can make that much money going like straight out of high school?
On the procon.org article, it said that as one of the cons that people would stop going to college because they think that they would be able to rely off of the minimum wage job since it would be like $15.
So if like the minimum wage went up in like general places like grocery stores and restaurants, would you expect like their products to increase in price?
Yeah, so I think that since they're going to have to pay their employees double, that they can't just keep like a bag of chips at like a dollar. They're going to have to increase that so they can keep up with like how much they have to pay their employees and how much money they're losing. Nate?
If minimum wage increases so that they have to decrease the amount of workers at a job, is there any statistics saying if that will help or hurt the economy?
Didn't see any.
So in the recent news, Amazon has now agreed that they would be paying all of their workers $15 an hour. Do you find anything about that or any other company who has gone to $15 an hour and the pressure that's putting on other businesses?
There, I think it was, I feel like New Hampshire or somewhere, or maybe Los Angeles, like that area, like those two areas, I can't remember which one it was. One of them raised their minimum wage rate, so all the businesses like surrounding it were losing like workers at their store because obviously if there's a job for $15, you're not going to want to work somewhere for $7.50. So that was like putting pretty big pressure on them.
Okay.